many people in attendance at an organ recital. I'm kind of taken aback. But I hope it's to your liking. This is a concert of music by Canadians for Canadians. And I tried to include as many people as I could whom I personally know. So I think it's roughly half and half. People who were great inspirations to previous generations and people who are great inspirations to the current generation. And I've just on the program sketched out just a couple of words about each composer, but I'll say one or two things now. I'm going to divide the show into roughly sets of three, and I'll speak every three pieces, just a few words about the works. So Canadian music has an identity all its own. If you were living in Canada 70 years ago or so, particularly in the English-speaking part of Canada, there would have been a tremendous British influence on the music that had been composed. It's much more diverse today with influences from around the world, and I've tried to include as many features of that in the program. As several of the works are modern, the harmonic palette and the aesthetic is sometimes perhaps unconventional to regular listeners of classical organ music, but we're really, really fortunate to have such a wonderful instrument such as is here at St. Andrew's Church that, although voiced and built in the classical style, is capable of performing effectively works from 8 or 9 different centuries. Now, we don't have that breadth of time represented in today's program, but nevertheless, a good century and a half of music is going to be performed here. So the first work on the program is in classical style, but it's written by a contemporary composer, Professor James McGowan, who teaches at Carleton University, and he's a respected colleague and a musician I admire very, very much. When I was putting the program together, particularly on social media, people tend to comment about things, as you may have noticed. And by even offering a list of composers, someone is always quick to say, well, why didn't you include this person, or why didn't you include that person? And sometimes the composers themselves write to me and say, well, would you please play my piece? So Professor McGowan did just that with his fugue on O Canada, which is written, if you will, a little bit in the style of the great master of counterpoint himself, J.S. Bach. And it's a great honor to our nation's national song to have it set in this way. And that'll begin the program. The second piece is by a good friend of mine, Benjamin Mallory. And he's a young composer who has really written quite a number of works over the past couple of years, trying to find his compositional voice and doing so very, very successfully. This piece was originally written for the piano, which I later adapted for the organ, and indeed recorded on my Atma Classique release from St. Paul's Church, Toronto, the wonderful organ there. And it's really going to be a joyful thing to play Ben's piece today. And then the third and final piece of the set is a colossal work, a toccata and fugue by my very illustrious friend and colleague, Andrew Ager. He's just sitting right down there, so he's an actual living composer in the room. One of a couple, actually, that are here today. And I think this is a magnificent work and one of the most important contemporary pieces for the organ written anywhere. And certainly that is true in Canada as well. This is also on my Atma Classique disc, and you may have detected a theme here. And that is to say that just this morning I discovered 5 or 6 of these things hanging around in my office. So if today you just have decided I haven't gotten enough of Matthew Larkin's organ playing, should that happen, there's a few for sale for $20 in the narthex, so I offer that to you humbly. So the three first works, Fugue by James McGowan, and works by Benjamin Mallory and Andrew Ager.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, let's see what we have next. All right, three works in the next set. The first of these, another good friend of mine, Paul Halley, Ottawa native, international recording artist and performer, composer of many fine works and arrangements of things, just a natural musician who can do pretty much anything. He is the organist of All Saints Cathedral, Halifax, and some years ago he was commissioned for the retirement of a colleague of his in the United States to write this fantasia on the hymn tune Nicaea, which is the tune to which Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty is, I think, almost exclusively sung. I don't think I've ever heard other words ever sung to Nicaea. Well, that's important because the hymn itself invokes the Trinity, and this work does as well. The movements are all interconnected, but one, the beginning features the Father, the second part features the Son, the third, the Holy Ghost, and the fourth, three in one. Following that, Dr. Healy Willen needs no introduction to any fan of Canadian church music. The number of works by Willen is in the many hundreds, and for the organ, probably over 100. Some are huge, some are miniatures. This is a miniature that he wrote in a collection that was published in 1962, and it's on the hymn tune Slain, which is sometimes sung to Be Thou My Vision, a very stirring text of early Irish extraction. But this one, he had in mind the evensong hymn At the End of the Day, so it's a very gentle treatment of the tune. And then the third and final piece of the set by the former conductor of the Toronto Symphony and the Toronto Mendelssohn Choir, Sir Ernest McMillan, his Cortège Académique, which is a wonderful military-style march, kind of a modern version of what Elgar would have written, composed for the Centennial of University College at the University of Toronto. And I'm dedicating this performance to Sir Ernest's two sons that I know and are good friends of mine, Ian and Don McMillan. Here is the second set, Halley, Willen, McMillan.
Thank you.
Now, for our next set of works, we feature firstly Ruth Watson Henderson, very famous Toronto-based pianist, organist, and composer. Longtime accompanist for Dr. Elmer Eisler in his years with the Mendelssohn Choir and with the Festival Singers of Canada. Ruth has written over 200 choral works. This organ work, however, was commissioned by the Toronto Centre of the Royal Canadian College of Organists about 20 years ago. It's a brief toccata on the hymn tune Westminster Abbey, to which is normally sung the text, Christ is made the sure foundation. Following that, Barry Cabina, very famous musician who's been resident in southwestern Ontario for certainly the second half of his career. Very dynamic organist and composer. And in the late 1960s, as a centennial project, and also as a way to honor several of his colleagues, he wrote a collection of pieces called Cabina's Homage. And this piece, which is written in Baroque style, the composer actually says, a la Pachelbel, on the score, was dedicated to Frederick Gagin. And if you were a fan of organ music 60 years ago, you would certainly have known the name Frederick Gagin. He was an Englishman who spent much of his career in Canada and was one of Canada's best-known organ recitalists in his career. I used to have a great friend at Christ Church Cathedral when I was organist there for many years, whose claim to fame was that she was Frederick Gagin's regular page-turner. And then the third and final piece of this set is by Gerald Bales, who had a very long and distinguished career, quite a bit of which was spent at the University of Ottawa, where he was a professor of music. And this is his best-known organ work, the Petite Suite, which, as the name suggests, is a short suite of three pieces, an introduction, the intermezzo, and the finale. The introduction really is quite striking at the beginning. It sounds a little bit like I've taken that piano and hurled it through that window. It's about that dramatic. So I hope you enjoy it. Very, very colorful, spicy flavored piece. Ruth Watson Henderson, Barry Cabina, and Gerald Bales.
Thank you.
The next set I will play as four. The first of these by Dr. Frederick Karam again, a distinguished Ottawa organist and choir master, spent much of his career at St. Elias Syrian Orthodox Church. He was conductor of the Ottawa Choral Society and also professor of music at the University of Ottawa. When the music department first opened, as a matter of fact, he was the first academic secretary. And there's quite a lineage here in the sense that he studied composition with Healy Willen, one of the earlier composers in the program. And his Divertimento was included in a collection of organ music from Canada, published in 1972. Kola Owolabi is a graduate of St. Michael's Choir School in Toronto, so another composer with choir boy training. He's had a very distinguished career. He's a very young man, but he is currently professor of music at the University of Notre Dame, and he has a distinguished academic record from McGill, Yale, and Eastman. Dr. Owolabi is a worldwide renowned composer and performer. This week, he is presenting at the first in-person convention of the American Guild of Organists in 3 years, which is taking place in Seattle, and he's one of the featured artists in that program. His dance was commissioned by the Royal Canadian College of Organists in 2005, and it has quite a track record, being the required composition in the RCCO playing competition in 2013. Which happened right here in this church, and that's the first time that I heard that work when I attended that competition. Gilles Leclerc, he's in the house today. He's the organist of Saint Francois d'Assise Church in Hintonburg. You can't miss it. It is a gigantic edifice, and he is very well known as a liturgical composer, organist, recitalist, choir director. He studied with Gerald Bales, amongst others, the person who I just finished the suite that was written by him. And this work was also commissioned by the RCCO for its national convention in Ottawa in the summer of 2002. And Gilles was the first Francophone national president of the college. This rhapsody on the tune Lasst uns erfreuen, a very well-known hymn tune which is frequently sung to all creatures of our God and King. And then the last composer on this set, a good friend of mine, recent graduate of York University, we worked together quite a bit. This is one of his new compositions, a meditation, well, a fanfare really, on the words of Psalm 100, O be joyful in the Lord, all ye lands. His Jubilate Deo will conclude this set. Thank you. thank you all so much. Apologies to Jill for hitting full organ at exactly the wrong time in his piece, and to Tate for trying to hit full organ, but instead just hitting a single four-foot flute in the middle of his piece. So these things all happen, you know, in real time. One of the great things about streaming things, if there's anything great to be said about streaming things in the pandemic, is that you could erase the mistakes and go back and do it again. But live music, wow, anything can happen. Thank you all so much for being here today. For our final piece, I didn't think it was possible to celebrate Canada Day without a bit of Joni Mitchell. So I'm going to come down to the piano and play one of my favorite Joni Mitchell songs, Case of You, from her record Blue, which was released in 1971. And in my little program notes there, it says that it was figured to be the 30th best album of all time, as voted by Rolling Stone magazine. So when you think about all of the records that have been made in the history of the world, for that to have been number 30, it's pretty good. For a young woman from Fort McLeod, Alberta, I met her once at a party. She kind of ghosted me, but I was only 18 or 19, so it's okay, Joni, I forgive you. Here is a case of you. I'm going to come downstairs and do that for you. Once again, thanks so much for being here, and thank you to James Porter for helping me out with the pages today, and for truly, he is the man. And for Norrell and everyone who helped out at the door from St. Andrews today and encouraged me along the way, thanks very much to all of you guys. One final reminder, want to take a little piece of Matthew home. There's a couple of these with your name on it at the front door. Thank you very much and have a very happy Canada Day. Just when you thought it was safe, I'm going to sing something at you.
Still be on my feet. in a box of paints. I'm frightened by the devil, and I'm drawn to those that ain't afraid. I remember that time you told me, you said love is touching souls. Surely you touched mine, 'cause part of you pours out of me in these lines from time to time. So sweet, I could drink a case of you, darling, and I could still be on my feet. Oh, I would still be on my feet.
I feel.